if you will, amen. We have a lot to pray for. There's just a lot the devil, the enemy, is fighting so hard. Amen. I have, I can't even tell you the messages I've received just today of people that are fighting, and the devil is, Sister Christine's coming in like he wants to. He wants to come in like a roaring lion. He's trying to destroy people. Amen. But I believe that greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. I still believe that. Amen. I still believe, Brother Matt, that God said that when the enemy comes in like a flood, like when the enemy comes in, the Bible says like a flood, God will raise a standard against him. Amen. I still believe those things. Amen. And you know, if we weren't doing something right in this church, the devil wouldn't be fighting so hard. Amen. And we're doing something right and the devil's mad. Amen. I thank God that he's mad, but we need to lift some people up in prayer. Amen. We really need to. There's some people, if you look around tonight, you'll notice who's not here. It's those people that need prayer tonight. Amen. Amen. So don't take it lightly. Amen. Don't take it lightly, because if you were fighting to hold on to everything you got, you'd want somebody to pray for you.
Amen.
Amen. Sister Wanda, would you take us to the Lord in prayer? To do something. Amen. And you know, Brother David, I was just sitting here, Brother David and I were talking earlier today about why the enemy is fighting so hard, but I want to tell the church this, and I don't know if it's appropriate or not, but Brother David and I had to take a real stand against some sinful things that were going on. And ever since then, it just seems like the devil has been trying to let us have it for taking a stand against sin, but I still believe that sin can't be behind the pulpit. You just call me old-fashioned, but I still believe sin can't be behind and up on this platform. I just believe that sin, not that I'm better than anybody. Come on, somebody, help me. Amen. You ain't no better than anybody. Amen. But greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, let's worship him for a moment. Can we lift up those hands? Come on, kids, young people, young adults, and teenagers. Hallelujah. Lord, we praise you, Jesus. Oh, God, we need you in this place tonight. Heavenly, shana mama mama mataya. Oh, in the name of Jesus. Help us to follow you, Heavenly Father. Hold me tight and touch the Lord as he goes by. You'll find he's not too busy to hear your pray for those that are up here tonight. Lord, just reach out and touch the Lord as He goes by. Through your find He's not too busy. Hallelujah. Oh, He is passing. Thank you. worship Him. Can we lift up a hand? Come on, kids, let's lift up our hands. Come on. Brother Noah, lift that little hand up and give God some love tonight. Tell Him how much you love Him, Lord Jesus. God, we need You in this place, Lord. Lord, I thank You tonight, Jesus.
No more at night. Now I'm no matter.
Amen. Yay. Oh, in the name of Jesus, I feel you tonight, Lord. Oh, I thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Lord. I can breathe again. Hallelujah. I can feel the rushing mighty wind in this place tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's receive the tithes and the offering. Amen. I thank God for what he is doing. Amen. The devil speaks defeat, but God speaks life. Amen. Yes, he does. Heavenly Father, we thank you again for your awesome spirit here tonight. Lord, we pray, God, that you would bless each one that has to give. And those that can't, don't, or won't, Lord, you see and you understand it. But Lord, we lift them up, God. And I pray tonight that you would have your way in this house, Lord, and bless Elijah, God, for as he brings the word later. And God, we ask that you would just move upon him and let the word penetrate our heart. Thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. God is just so good. Somebody have a praise tonight while we receive the offering. Amen. Anybody got a praise? Anybody else thank God? Amen. Brother Terry.
Not a bad accident. We're all at home. And I guess doing okay. I heard from the mother, they had to fix a hole in her diaphragm. Other than that, she's talking on Facebook. If you're on Facebook, you're okay.
Amen to that. I agree with you. If you're on Facebook, you're okay. Amen. Somebody else got a praise. Elijah.
I want to praise God today because Monday morning of last week, I was so overcome by the Spirit just all of a sudden that I broke down crying. And I had some coworkers with me, and we were all just in the Spirit at that moment. And it was just a huge blessing to me that even though no matter how often or how much that I have sinned in my life, God will be there for me and he will forgive me just like that. No Amen. Matter what it is, just confess with your soul, repent, and God will forgive you.
Amen. The righteous man falls, but he gets back up. Amen. The righteous man falls, but he gets back up. Sister Kayla, you have a song. Give that baby, Sister Ashley, get up here. And Sister Ashley, hold that baby all night if you let her. Amen. Come on. Bless us tonight. Somebody else got a praise while she's coming. Amen.
Marching around tonight reminded me of when I used to march around the church.
Yes.
I just enjoy the young people.
Me too.
Enjoy God. I love him tonight.
Amen. Me too. Me too. Brother Jayden, stand up. Praise the Lord. Amen. I want to thank everybody for making Riker feel at home today. He's a boy that's lost, just trying to find himself. And you all made him feel loved. And Cameron and Jayden and Ethan and Maya, I was so proud of how they just welcomed him into the church. Amen. And we just need to pray for that young fellow. These kids, man, I don't know how you guys do it, but I pray for them every day, Brother Matt. I know you do. That God would give him strength. Amen. Let me try to get this going here.
Thank you.
pray some more for us tonight?
I just thank the Lord for being here tonight. I thank Him for everything He's brought me through. I thank Him for Brother Elijah's testimony, because I found myself there so many times. And I thank God for His love. And I thank God so much for His grace. And I thank God that, like He was saying, like, God can meet you anywhere. Amen. Wherever you are, in the car. You don't have to be here.
Amen.
But He can meet you right where you're at. And I love the Lord. And I know I fail the Lord at times, but He never fails me. And I thank Him so much for that.
Thank you, Jesus. Sister Christy, it's been requested you sing "He Left It All" tonight before Elijah ministers. Amen. God is so good. I feel Him tonight. It's just bubbling in my heart. If I'm the only one, maybe it's crazy, but I just feel Him here tonight. I want to say to those that are watching by Facebook, God sees every struggle. He sees everything. Don't be afraid to call on the name of the Lord.
He didn't bring an army to help him on his way. He didn't bring an angel to praise him night and day. He didn't bring
oh. Amen. Let's give God a big hand tonight. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm so glad that the young adults are in here. I got a call from a very wise lady, Aunt Gail, and she said, on Sunday nights, I just feel like the young people are supposed to be in the service. And she said, the Lord spoke that to me. Brother Matt, God had already been dealing with him on that, and I didn't know it. Amen. And I'm like, well, let's do it. And I thank God they're in here. Amen. I love these kids. I thank God.
Spirit on that day at work. And it just overcame me because of how true it is. Now, I'm going to do my best to sing this song. Now, I don't know whether I'm going to sing this slow or fast. But,
Lord Jesus, help me. Praise the exalted Holy God, maker of all the earth and the sky, holy, holy King of glory, worship the Son of God, Jesus Christ, glory to the Holy Spirit rise. You deserve all the honor. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. Praise the exalted Holy God, maker of all the earth and the sky. Holy, holy King of glory, worship the Son of God, Jesus Christ. Glory to the Holy Spirit will rise. You deserve all the honor. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. Holy, holy, holy God Almighty, holy, holy, holy God Almighty. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God. You're the one we call the true Almighty God.
Now I know I butchered those.
those lyrics horribly.
Message here now is about sin and the modern church. Now, what exactly is sin? Now, the Bible states that sin is an act of transgression. It means that you have broken God's law. Now, a lot of people believe in the world that there are different levels of sin, but the reality of it is that God sees sin, no matter how we think, how great or small, he sees it all the same. That's something that a lot of people get wrong with, is God sees it all exactly the same. Whether you stole a pen, or God forbid you murdered somebody, he sees it the same. People who are blind to their sin are going to think this. As I said, oh, well, I may have done this, but at least I didn't do that. They have that in their mind, and that is the devil that is talking to them and saying, oh, you just only did this. You didn't do anything that bad. They are going to think, it's going to be implanted in their mind, and it's going to blind them. It will literally blind them mentally of their sin. And sadly, there is a lot of people in this world that think that way, and God help them. So I have a couple of scriptures here as well. First John chapter 1, verse 8 is, if we claim to be without sin, we are deceiving ourselves.
Amen.
Again, being blind and being lost in the world. The Bible states, again, multiple times to confess, acknowledge that we have done something wrong. That's what confessing is.
Amen.
And repent, meaning to change our ways, not just physically speaking, but the renewing of your mind.
Amen.
By renewing your mind and renewing your spirit. Now, what could exactly be pleasing unto the Lord as a way of repentance? That would be fasting, praying, reading your Bible, seeking God and creating a stronger and better relationship with Him. That's what God wants. That's what pleases God. Now, I love this verse here as well. Just the next verse after 1 John 8, 1 John 9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and cleanse us all from unrighteousness. And honestly, this just gets me emotional, because just to think of all the things that I have done in my life.
Yes.
The sin that I have committed
Amen.
In my life, God has forgiven me all the way.
Yes.
No matter what you've been through, it is never too late to call on the name of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Come on.
Oh, Lord, forgive me for the sins I've committed against you.
Yes.
Forgive us all for our transgressions that we have done.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Now, what about the modern church now? Now, this is where I may ruffle some feathers. Oh, Lord. Oh, forgive me. Now, the modern church, sadly, is filled with liars who twist God's word to their own benefit, to their own will to seek something to gain. Now, they have their own agenda, and Christ himself warned us about these so-called prophets. And now, if you want to turn to Matthew chapter 7, verses 15 through 20 is what I'm going to read. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
give y'all a second. Chapter 7, verse 15. Alrighty, amen. Now in verse 15, it says, "Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are raving wolves."
Amen.
And it says, "Ye shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of thistles? Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, and neither a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit.
Amen.
Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire.
Amen.
Wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them."
Amen.
Now, what do I think of the modern church? Again, I believe that the modern day church has been overrun. It's been corrupted by men and women who they say they call themselves Christians, but in reality, they're not.
Amen.
We have to think about that for a sec, because there are so many churches, if I remember the statistic, 2,000 churches every year are closed down. I wonder why that is. Now, here's a lot of mega church pastors, like Joel Osteen, Kenneth Copeland, and Jesse Duplantis, I believe is how to say that last name, are just a few examples of these corrupt religious leaders.
Amen.
Because they don't preach God's word, they preach a prosperity gospel.
Yeah.
They say, "Oh, if you give this or this amount of money, I promise you God will send you a blessing." Now, in some cases that may be true, but I don't think I can give $1,000 right here and now just to get one little blessing. I promise you.
That's right.
I don't. Another thing I love a lot of these people having, these pastors have in common, or quote unquote pastors, is that they all have these lavish lifestyles. They have these mansions, they have these private jets, and they have all of this stuff. And the thing is, it's not in their name. It's in the church's name. And there's a reason for that. They use the church as like a loophole for a tax exemption, as I found out. I'm getting to this legally, hold on. Section 170 of the Kentucky Constitution states that real property owned and occupied and personal property, there goes the mansions, the private jets, all of that, owned by institutions of religion are exempted from taxation. So all that stuff, that's how he's managed to get so rich that quick. So what do I think of megachurch pastors? I think they are nothing more than a bunch of greedy, corrupt human beings doing the work of the devil. They're following their own will and their own ideology. Now, I will say this. Tithing is important, but nowadays, it's just, 10%. Yeah, not 5, 10. We all remember that, 10. I'm preaching myself too, don't worry. Tithing is important, but nowadays, a lot of people see it as a contest to flex how much money they make. I see that's very common, especially in mega churches like this. Lord, felt that. God tells us to fast, pray, and spread his good news. Here's something in my notes that I wrote down. Those who have little to give, give more than any rich person out there.
Amen.
They sacrifice more of their needs for God, while the rich sacrifice very little. $2,000 ain't nothing to them. Because they know they'll have enough, more than enough, to take care of not just their needs, but many of their wants. Now, I have a Luke chapter 21 is where I want to go to. Verse 1. You have it, say amen. And he looked up and saw the rich men casting their gifts into the treasury. And he saw also a certain poor widow casting in thither two mites. And he said, of a truth I say unto you, that this poor widow hath cast in more than they all. For all these have of their abundance cast into the offerings of God. But she hath her penury, I said that wrong, hath cast in all the living that she hath. Tithe this, well, this mega church, quote unquote, tithing, that little contest, is only the tip of the iceberg of what the modern church is doing wrong. A lot of churches nowadays are supporting gay marriage, transgenderism, and a whole of other beliefs that contradict what the Bible teaches us. Now in Luke chapter 11, verses 29 through 32. And when the people were gathered together, thick together, he began to say, this is an evil generation. They seek a sign, and there shall be no sign be given it, but the sign of Jonas the prophet. For as Jonas was a sign unto the Ninevites, so shall the Son of Man be to this generation. The queen of the south shall rise up in the judgment with the men of this generation and condemn them, for she came from the utmost parts of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon, and behold, a greater than Solomon is here. The men of Nineveh shall rise up in the judgment with this generation and shall condemn it, and they repented at the preaching of Jonas, and behold, a greater than Jonas is here. The modern day church is why so many people have fallen away. Because obviously, this modern day church gives no wisdom. It gives nothing to create, give them something better, to better themselves through Christ. So, why have so many people have fallen away from Christ? Is because in modern day church you have a lot of judging, a lot of gossiping, a lot of lusting, pride, greed, gluttony, you name it. It has completely overrun the church, taken over many people's lives.
Amen.
Again, that they have gone blind to it.
Amen.
It is now more important than ever to reach out to our lost brothers and sisters.
Amen.
Those who need us.
Amen.
The alcoholics, the drug addicts,
yes.
Even our own friends and family members.
Yes.
Amen.
We must reach out to them. And honestly, call them out for their sin. Because calling them out for their sin is not an act of hate. It is an act of love.
Amen.
Because you are showing them that this is wrong. And starting to try and lead them towards Christ. Towards a better life that they can have. Now in closing, we must all call out the hypocrisy of the church, or it will only get worse. Call out those people who call themselves Christians, but do not live a life according to God's will. Now, pray for the church. It needs it now more than ever. Christ is returning very soon. We may only have a few days. We may only have a few minutes. We don't know the time, nor the day, nor the hour. Now, is there anyone around here who needs prayer? Anyone at all? Hannah, Jaden, you guys need prayer? Okay. Does anybody need prayer at all? Now's the time. Because we don't know if our time's about to come when we walk out those doors. We may not be here next Sunday. We may not be here tomorrow. Now is the time. Yeah.
Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank God for that word tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want us to pray tonight before we dismiss. We need to pray for the Cases, their little son. What's his name?
Emmerich.
Emmerich. Amen. He has a double ear infection, and God can heal that. Amen. We need to pray for Sister Haley tonight. I want to lift her up in prayer tonight, and I want to pray for the Lumpkins. Amen. They are hurting. Amen. I want to pray for them. So tonight, as Sister Christy comes, if you'll just come and give us a course. Amen. If you do need prayer, as Elijah said, tonight's the night. It's the night of repentance. Amen. And how true it is that we all sin and come short of the glory of God. A righteous man falls, but he gets back up.
Amen.
He doesn't stay down. He gets back up. Sister Chris, a righteous man or woman, we don't trip, fall, and just wallow around in the mud. Amen. But we get back up. We clean ourselves off. We ask God to forgive us. Amen. That's what separates the Christian from the non-Christian.
Amen.
The non-Christian don't think they sin or they do anything wrong. Amen. But the Christian knows. And we try to live a life that is better, pleasing unto Christ. Lord Heavenly Father, we come to you tonight. We lift up Emmerich. God, that baby needs a healing in his body. And Lord, I pray for Elizabeth and Andrew tonight, God, that you would touch that little family. Lord, that you would bless them with what they have need of and draw them to your side. Lord, that they may hunger and thirst more for your righteousness. We lift up Sister Haley tonight. God, as she is at home sick and the enemy is just fighting her on every angle. But Lord, we know that greater is he that is in her than he that is in the world. And God, we ask you tonight to touch our sister, Lord, to give her strength to overcome. Lord, we are greater. We are more than overcomers through Christ that strengthens us. Tonight I pray, Lord, that you help her, show her. God, we pray for the Lumpkins that are suffering, Lord, that are hurting in their hearts and in their minds, and the enemy is just coming in and ravishing their life. But God, we ask for deliverance, Lord, and we pray also tonight for Jean Moody that's watching by Facebook. I pray that you touch my sister. I love her immensely. And God, I pray for a great move of God and touch in her life for whatever she has need of. And every need that is here, every child, every teenager, God, that is here tonight, you see what they are going through. And Lord, you understand the times that they live in and the peer pressure and things that they go through at school and the, Lord, the different circumstances that take place around them every day. But we pray for your strength. Lord, we pray for your peace. We pray for your joy. And God, we pray for your standard. In the name of Jesus, we ask. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
If you need prayer tonight, amen, or you want to come pray for somebody or stand in for somebody, please obey the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Go ahead, Sister Chris. Thank you. here at the building, they'll be finishing up some work in the bathrooms and on. So just pray that everything is good. Amen. And that God touches. We will be having, as we close, we'll be having a work day on a Saturday very soon. We want to move some things in the Sunday school rooms and move my office so that we can open up the wall between what is now the nursery and Sister Chelsea's room, because simply Sister Chelsea has too many kids. So we've got to open up that room so she has a larger room. Amen. And so we'll need some help with that and just general cleaning out in the fellowship hall. Amen. So just remember that's coming up this weekend, Friday and Saturday. Amen. It's supposed to rain. So rain or shine, we'll have a garage sale at my house. Amen. So and the Merkley meet will be in Saturday. Brother David and I will pick that up. So if you have items you want to donate to the yard sale, feel free to bring them by the house anytime. Sister Alvy will be home. Amen. And we have a busy week, but just message me. Let me know you're coming so I know somebody's there. Amen. Would you stand with us, please? Amen. All you kids, all you teenagers, thank you for worshiping the Lord tonight. Little Hannah, it was so good to see you worshiping the Lord tonight. Thank you. Thank you for doing that. Amen. And Cadence, I saw your arm up raising the Lord. And little Micah back there. It's just beautiful to see their arms lifted, marching around this church. They'll never forget that. They'll never forget that. Amen. All hearts and minds clear tonight. Yes.
Keep me and Chelsea in prayer as we travel up to Illinois back Thursday and Friday.
Yeah, Brother Tony's going to a minister's conference, so let's remember that. Amen. Brother Bays, would you dismiss us?
Father, now in Jesus, we thank you for that chance to come together and worship, to praise you, to be blessed by you, to bless you. In our glorious holy name, Jesus, we thank you for thy word. We thank you for thy spirit. Lord, be with us.